The video presented by HCF Creative King Advertising and Marketing Solution ABCD Anybody Can Dance Friend Events and Rentals.
Welcome to Gupshup Show with me, Muhammad Nizamuddin Nishad. Today our guest, Mrs. India Universe Popular, Mrs. Meena Asrani. Welcome in our show, Mrs. Meena Asrani.
Thank you so much, Nizamuddin, for having me here.
You're welcome. Meena Asrani, she is model and actress also. Today we will understand about how she struggled, how she had a passion about like dance, modeling or fashion or corporate. So we will go with Mrs. Meena Asrani step by step, what are the achievements she did. So first of all, I would like to know, Mrs. Meena Asrani, how you started your career from India to UAE?
Definitely. Just like an Indian girl, I'm from a Pandit family. So for me, modeling was a big no-no. And I was very restricted towards what I'm wearing, with whom I'm talking. Actually, my career started when I came here in Dubai after my marriage. And after my delivery, I was so busy with my son, with my family, that I could not even think of starting my modeling career. I was not even thinking a single person of my own self. I was completely dedicated toward my kid, towards the family.
So how you inspired into modeling fashion, as you say that your family was from very traditional family, and how you started your career about this industry?
I have been always busy after my delivery, taking care of my son, settling up here in Dubai. After delivery, say my son was around three years old, and there was an event, and I gave a small dance performance there. And during my performance, nobody could believe that I'm already a mother. And there I found a friend. She was holding a Pakistani clothing brand, and she approached me. She asked me for doing modeling for her brand. Initially, I was running from this because, as I told you, I could never thought of taking out time for doing something for my own self. But then she had been asking me for this, and one fine day she caught me and she was like, "No, you have to do this for me." Then okay, I just like for a friendly gesture, I did my first photo shoot, and I still remember my first shoot. When I went there, I was very scared, and I was having zero knowledge about makeup, and the makeup artist, she started my makeup thing. I was not comfortable the way she was doing my eyes and my lipsticks and all. But then yes, this is how it started, and the pictures turned out to be very good. And people started approaching me for more shoots. So this is how it started.
So as you said, your family was a very traditional, and after this photograph shoot and all, so how your husband and your in-laws, they reacted about that? Because as you said, your parent was a very traditional family. So might be your parent was not liking these kind of activities. Even mostly Indian family, they doesn't like these kind of activities.
Definitely, not only Indian family, more than Indian family, it's very difficult to convince Indian society that someone after getting married, doing modeling and doing shoots. In fact, when I left for my beauty pageant, my son was only 3.5 years, and everybody have been calling and complaining to my husband that how can she leave the son, he's just 3.5 years old. But I always highlight that I'm having a very supportive and very loving husband. He told me that yes, he's my son also, he's not only your responsibility, please go ahead. Definitely, after my first shoot, my shoot was very nice, very decent. I was doing shoot for saris. My mom was not much happy, but my dad have been always supportive since the day he have seen me. I have been doing taking part in a lot of dancing and singing competitions in my college time also. So he have been always supportive. So yes, I got support from two very important men in my life, my dad and my husband.
As you said, you have one kid. So how you are maintaining your fitness? Because in UAE, it's a very difficult to maintain fitness, because it's a very challenging, especially after delivery, it's a very challenging for women to maintain, and not only physically as well as mental balance. So what is your suggestion for people who after a delivery, they feel depressed, they feel about physical maintenance? So what is your suggestion? What is your advice for them?
Definitely after pregnancy, it's said that a woman gets another birth. Okay, and I have seen a lot of women, they get into depression because 24/7 they're only listening to the baby crying, taking care of them, the whole house is in a mess. But same thing happened with me also, but yeah, I didn't went for depression. In fact, I use this time for myself, and what happens is, like, now and in Dubai especially, what you mentioned is very difficult to maintain your fitness. I am a very big foodie, no doubt. I eat a lot. But what you eat is very important, and when you eat is also very important. What I suggest for women, that definitely don't kill your taste buds. Please eat what you feel like eating, but eat in less quantity. Do not eat a lot of food altogether. Eat food in small proportions. Like, as you know, I am also a corporate leader. And throughout the day, if you come and see next to my desk, there's a lot of food things like nuts, chocolate bars, a lot of things are there. So whole day, I'll keep munching a little, but I do not stuff myself altogether. And apart from that, because my father, like, no, he was a teacher, now he's retired. So since being itself, he made sure that we do a little of yoga every time. And that's what the magic is still working on me. Looking at my face, my glow, my physique, it's more about yoga. Yoga is having a very slow impact on you, but it's a long-lasting impact. Unlike the gymming thing. Gymming gives you a very fast, change in your body. But once you stop it, it will come back to you also very fast.
It will be the side effect for that.
Correct. So it's always said that, eat in small proportions. And especially you start your day with a heavy breakfast. Go for a minimum meal for your lunch. And dinner, please keep your food. Try to have a little of fruits and then milk and have your sleep.
So tell me, what are your achievements? I had shared with you. So if you can share about your achievements, how you did, and what is your suggestion for coming generation?
I have achieved the title of Mrs. India Universe, popular 2018, which was last year only. And after achieving that, you know what happens when you go for a beauty pageant, a lot of people from the modeling industry and film industry also come. So after that, a lot of people have started approaching me to come to Bombay, and even from the Netflix also people approached me. But only concern is, if I have to get into this completely, I have to be in Bombay, and I am working here, I have my family here. So as I said, always you set your priorities. I have my priorities. My priority is my son. So because of whom I'm not able to leave and get into the modeling or into film industry 100%. But yes, whatever comes in Dubai and whatever good work, especially I always highlight that I prefer to go for good work, comes in Dubai, I do that. I have done shoots for a lot of clothing brands, makeup brands, and in fact, a lot of Pakistani and Punjabi music albums also have done.
So what is your next goal? What is your next strategy for coming your new project? So can you share about your new project? What are the new project is coming? So our viewers, they can watch, they can observe, like, what? Because, you know, if you are into this industry, a lot of people, they are excited to know about you. What is new? Your project is coming. So can you share about your new upcoming project?
Definitely. I would like to highlight my upcoming projects to all my fans and followers that I am soon going to do a music album for T-Series, and for which my choreography is already started. And apart from that, from my beauty pageant, I have seen, especially when I went for my own beauty pageant, I have seen women coming from different part of India, even from villages and all, who have not even wore sleeveless, never wore heels. And when this time I went to train these women as a personality groomer, I really felt so good. You know, it's a kind of empowering the current world, empowering the women. So my focus is now more towards training and grooming such women who really have caliber, beauty and talent to present India on international platform. So now I'm focusing more towards doing the international personality grooming, which will give India and Indian women a better platform to present themselves on international platform.
It's a really good to know about you, your goals and future planning. So what else your suggestion for coming generation? How they can prepare, like, balance personal, professional, corporates, as you said that you work for corporates also. So in corporates also, how they can manage, and especially if someone is coming in UAE, and they need a job also. So what is your suggestion for job kind of aspect, family kind of aspect, as well as like balancing between personal and professional life? Because my main focus is like for new generation, what are the new generation is coming, they should do for betterment for not only for personal life as well as professional life. They should balance between personal and professional life, as well as they should be a role model for others also. Because after coming here, a lot of a struggle is coming. You must have seen a lot of a struggle. So can you share about a few your struggle, some any painful story that people, they will listen you, and how you come up from that negative to positive things? As you said, you are yoga practitioners. As I know that yoga practitioner, yoga people, they always kill on negative energy. They always focus with positive energy. So please share about that few things.
Talking about my bitter experiences, first I'll share something about my professional career thing. Before working with my current organization, I was working also same line of business. I'm into distribution field for around 10 years. So my previous company, I would not like to highlight the name, but wasn't a good experience for me. I came to this company, it's like blessing for me. My new company, they're like, very supportive. And this is like, they are one of the reason where I got a chance and where I got time to do my modeling and to conquer my dreams. But talking about my previous company, this was more like, they were not happy with me doing anything apart from work. And the company was good. But what happens is, even if you have a very good company, but the line manager is not good, I'm sorry, you cannot work with that company. Even if the company is bad, but the line manager is good, you're blessed. But with me, it was opposite, and my line manager was more like a dominating, and a lot of people started leaving the company because of the line manager. So that was a very bitter experience. More than my work, he was more interested to know what I'm wearing, where I'm going, what I'm talking. So he had been pushing, because I said no to a lot of his unwanted demands. He had been pushing for me to resign, but I didn't quit. Because you must be knowing, in corporate world, what happens? If you leave the job, unless you get another job, you have been taken as you're not able to handle the pressure. You're not able to take the challenge. And I didn't want to put that on my CV, that I was not able to handle the pressure. So I was still struggling. And there were times when it was told to the staff not even to talk to me. I used to go sit alone, work, come back. I started looking for a job and I really got a very good job. So I always tell the generation, don't lose your focus. Stay focused. Don't worry about what surrounding is telling. If you know what you're doing is correct, please keep doing it.
Thanks for coming in our show, Mrs. Meena Ashrani. It was a pleasure to know about you, about how you did struggle, how you make your career, how you make good communication with your husband and family, and to convince them this industry is not bad. So it will be definitely those viewers they are watching our show. Definitely it will be good inspiration for those people. They will learn a lot of things, and a lot of people what they was thinking about that I can't do, but definitely after knowing about your successful story, definitely they will do and they will try to do better in life. Thank you.
Thank you so much for inviting me here and giving such a good platform to share our stories with the audience.
Thank you.
Thank you.